I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody. It's your Coverage of the Defense, season number 3. We are halfway through our week. I say halfway through our week. We had a bit of a day off before, and then we go all the way into Sunday. We don't care about weekends over here at Join Dota. All we care about is very, very good Dota. And we should have ourselves a couple of fun games tonight. KP with a doubleheader awaiting them now in their first game up against 4FC, the guys who were able to defeat Empire just before it. Because if you want to check out the group stages, you can just do so over at the-defense.com. Or you can just look at the group, which is now sitting in front of you, and you'll see exactly where we're looking at. Group B is where we are looking for this game. 4-1 already for 4FC. They are tied with Team Empire after 5 games, sitting on that second position. Team Dignitas, of course, they haven't managed to play their 5th game just yet, but they have a big one coming up on Friday night, and that's going to be a very, very rough game for them. Of course, we look over to our other boys, KP, as well as 4FC. They're next to each other on this list, but not next to each other in the standings. That is Pain Gaming. The Brazilians will manage to push themselves up a little bit further in front next to Mortal Teamwork. And it is still, however, KP 1-3 and 4FC sitting at 4-1. So this is kind of a must-win game here for KP if they want to make sure they can get themselves into the top portion of the group, because it is only the top 4 that will advance through into the playoffs. And that is all what we want to see from everybody. We're all about like everyone getting through into the playoffs. But unfortunately, only half the teams can do so. So, hey, let's look at our draft right now. 4FC, they're going to start off with possibly the strongest mid-soloer in the game. And that is the Batrider. However, RMN, they managed to sneak through the NA. Magnetor and Wisp being the bans out by 4FC. So no matter what would happen here, they were going to get at least one of these boys through. And then Undying and Darkseid, the bans out by RMN. Either way, there's still stable bans up here in the European scene, but we do know what Coddle as well as NA are capable of achieving. Like, NA just screws around with every single team fight. It's nice initiator, nice little bit of mana burn too, so any hero who has a little bit low of mana pool is dangerous for them. And then you get all the mana in the world from Coddle through his chakra, not to mention the harassment on the lanes. So 4FC, they go with steel and they go with strength. And then it's going to be Rubick for the steel. Amping, which is the strength of KP, will be taken and then thrown to help out the lone druid to help him push down towers very, very early on. Of course, Ruby's got a nice little bit of level of control as well. Lone druid, he's able to go safe lane, or he can go on the long lane. Most teams have been running him on the safe lane if you're looking over towards the Chinese scene. But surprisingly enough, over here in Europe, I see more lone druids going on the long lane than I have the safe lane. For guys too who saw out my tweets, I explained it a little bit before we started off. We're going to use the new setup on Friday. So Friday is when the new setup will be installed, and we need time to disassemble the studio and reassemble the studio. So if you didn't check it out over on Toby1Dota's Twitter, which is my own, then you'll find out everything that you'll need to know. So yeah, it is the images of the CPU usage. It's nice. It'll be good to have a little bit more of a stabler streaming set up here, which will make the viewing experience a lot nicer for you guys at home, hopefully. All right, so how are we going to go now? Invoker bans out. Radiant team. Is this just 4FC trying to focus on the mid solos? Templar Assassin still available as well, but Batrider. Dire team ban. I feel that TA is no real threat. Refraction charges aren't really his thing to worry about. Drag it through with that last two through the fire. And the only downside is Batrider gets a lot of harassment on the lane when, like, before you try and initiate in. Which means you need a decent amount of consumables. But he's still going to ban out any hero that can cause issues in the mid. So Queen of Bane being taken out too. They're not even worried about banning off the long laner here of KP, because they probably also realize there's no point in it. Because no matter what happens here, like KP, we can see that Luna pickup come in the 4th position, and then just a mid-solo selection, can't be whoever they want it to be. And then they see NA, Coddle, and PL all head up towards the top lane. Every single PL that we've seen play has been played defensively over here in Europe as this, in case they get anti-mage hero, and also some nice pressure on the lane later on. And KP, in fact, can abandon Luna themselves. This Luna being that hero that has been pretty successful up against PL. The biggest problem with PL is always the fact that it just overwhelms you with all of these PLs. And Tinker is that final ban. Nice ban. Which means kind of like Iron Man is forced to run the TA in the middle lane unless he wants to go with a different style of lane. which we have seen as well from KP. Of course, in KP's last match up against Empire, they ended up running that Luna Undying NNA. So they got the NA and the Coddle back again. So it was Bomberg as well as Esoloco up on that Coddle. Team pick. But then they tried to played around with the Quap, the Luna, as well as the NA in that one, and they did a really good job at that. Like it was this. I think it was actually that was the Undying and Coddle lane. It was very, very crazy as far as the laning went. But they ban out Undying this time around, so they can't do it this time. And now 4FC finished off the bans. Lashrak, Shadow Demon, anything which little couples with Rubick, apart from Lina. Lina is still the option for 4FC. Nice little bit of an AoE stunner, as well as counter push itself. Reserve time. I don't know if that was a line they really wanted to do. Like, were they looking at tower melding? Because if that's the case, then, well, we could still see, do we try it? Do we try and go for Lycan? Do we buff up the Howl and go nuts on it? Could also mean that 4FC would have a chance of going for a level 1 Roshan. I mean, that's something for KP to check out for. Because 4FC are sitting on the dire side for this game. This will be good to see our stand-in for KP. Not always good to see a stand-in, but Sexy Bamboo is always great to see him in the mix. RMN, Pylite, Eye Teaser, as well as Quachka. Seriously, worst name in history, but best name in history at the same time. Hello, Jakiro. Jakiro will be the selection, so we get the Ice Path add-on. Kind of surprising about that, though. Even though he does have a lot of strength, it's... You can find his mana pool severely decreased by NA if he gets a couple levels up in that mana burn. Not to mention the initiation that can come out on both Rubick as well as Jakiro. Can hurt like hell when there's a Coddle follow-up blast. Bounty Hunter. And now we're going to add in the invis movement of Bounty Hunter. Which does make our lanes a little bit more interesting as far as KP goes. Picking up the Bounty Hunter, obviously you want some easy levels up on him, but the problem he's going to have... Sorry. Just checking the chat for the moment.
10 seconds remaining.
Alright, so Bounty Hunter as well as Lone Druid anyway. This is one of those things where Bounty Hunter up against a Lone Druid. It's not gonna be too bad when he jumps in and out of his invis, and he can harass on the Lone Druid directly once he gets the 2 points up in Janata and just the 1 point in Ghost Walk. And you're able to move in, harass, then move back out again, get some nice tranquil boots. But the problem he gets is when he's entangled. If Lone Druid gets up to that higher level, then you're in a lot more trouble. And they're going to go with Kunkka here for FC. It does really feel like an aggressive tri lane from them. Leave Batrider in middle and then the Lone Druid to solo on the top. Which means PL, Coddle, and NA will go up against Rubick, Jakiro, Kunkka. No matter what happens, they want that lane to happen anyway. But KP, they've got to go that Templar Assassin for the middle lane unless they have something else to go up against a Batrider. But TA doesn't really want to. Gyrocopter will be an option. But he'll get a little bit weaker as the game goes on if Rubick gets a couple of points up in Null. Because most of the damage is magical from Gyrocopter. So it has to be a different style of option. But 4FC shut them down pretty hard in that middle lane. They banned out all the good heroes up against Batrider. Because of this, RMN has a really hard decision. I actually kind of thought he would go down a different line instead of going the Bounty Hunter and look towards more dual lanes. So try and team someone up with the NA that can go up against the Batrider or have a little bit more extra harassment. Even if it be to the point of a Coddle on the long lane and then throw NA pulling support even just Coddle and PL in the middle lane would have been a fun lane. And then Bounty can go solo, NA can support. And that's still a possibility. But I think RMN might even just go, like, stay the storm and pick up a Brewmaster. Have that kind of lockdown that comes out later on. That's going to be a lot better up against the Lone Druid. The only issue he's going to have is in the early part, is getting any kind of CS. But that will be the trade-off for them. They won't look for the CS. They'll have to look for the levels to start with. But that does give Batrider a license to kill, and they go with a Puck instead. So we go phase shift, orbing, trying to get yourself away, and that's actually a lot smarter pickup. And we get ourselves now inside the game. So let's do it. For FC. Strang B, Mr. Torrent to start with. Good to see that. I've seen some Kunkers already go with X marks to spot as their first ability, and it makes you just want to facepalm. But they are going to run the aggressive try lane down on bot. So Rubik heading down there right now with Boomski, the Jakiro, and Strang B, the Kunker, which puts our middle lane solo, which I doubt is going to be Krilly. It'll be Nose. Yep, Nose is built. A little bit extra consumables for him at the early stages of the game, but he will be looking for that very early bottle. Well, not as early, just decently early. And then Lone Druid. Should be Stout Shield and Quelling Blade. No, we actually gone Ring of Protection to start with. Up on the Spirit Bear. A little bit surprising at that. And are we going to see this duel off lane again with the Coddle? This must just be KP's signature. No, they are running the aggressive tri lane. Teaser will stick around with them. Which puts our mid lane RMN solo
to battle.
And Bamboo. He's going to have to do it pretty tough on the bottom lane. This isn't what he wants to do. He's going to check for Roshan. He feels it because they haven't seen anybody just yet. So Roshan's empty. Forced to waste a little bit of mana, but we'll stay up on the high ground. Problem is when he comes back in again, he'll instantly see Nose, and then his Ghost Walk runs out and Nose will see him. So it is going to be an aggressive trialing by 4FC down here. They throw down the sentry wards already looking for Bamboo. And Bamboo wants the 0-minute room, which he will not find. And another sentry ward to drop down. Pick up, they can throw him up on the cliff. And they do so as well. Bamboo, he's got 6 tango charges. And he can be perfectly seen here. Eats his way through. And now right-clicked up. There's no telekinesis in 8 seconds time. And Bamboo copying a lot of damage. Picked up, Torrin is there too. And maybe with a couple more right-clicks, they get it too. 4FC. Spilling the first blood against Sexy Bamboo, and that was just a commitment of 2 sentry wards to do that. And then instantly swapping the lanes. Put a haste rune up on Krilly. He heads down towards the bottom lane. This tri lane's already got themselves a nice kill on the Bounty Hunter, and they're rotating out towards the top lane. They are losing a little bit of time, which will be some nice levels for PL. But yeah, 4FC realizing the lanes are different for KP, so they move their tri lane back to a defensive lane. And Coddle and NA wait for them, waiting for someone to rotate up the quick way. The Observer Ward is already there, not blocking the camp. So 4FC might not feel like there's some vision here. But they're looking for that opening. Yeah, the Rubik is what they would like. He's the easier one to pick off out of all of them. But Kunker is the better one. Get the man that wants the farm. Well, PL continues to get his. 5-for-3 up for him, 6-for-1, as you would expect for the Batrider in the middle lane up against the Puck. Puck, the fact he's managed to stay alive and not have to use so many consumables is a testament to RMN right now. And now he'll down towards the bottom lane, so Krilly. Oh, there we go, Orb of Venom up on the bear. And this is the harassment the Bamboo can't deal with. He'll get no CS on this lane whatsoever, or shouldn't at least. See him already getting just right-clicked down a little bit. He's doing a lot of damage to Krilly, however. That Janata hits hard. And he's not even level 3 yet. He's waiting for the 2 points up in Janata before we'd see Krilly being forced to use Sals, but he's already been forced to do so. No point harassing the bear, just harass the hero directly. Nose again, playing around with RMN. Just a quick phase shift. Very, very quick. Has himself already 9 stick charges, because it's the best thing you can do when you go up against a hero like Batrider. Every single time Napalm is cast, you get yourself a stick charge. And get the wand up as early as possible. All that kind of like napalm harassment just strengthens the opposition. We're looking at 2-minute runes. Rune spawns on bottom, so we got an illusion rune down there. RMN is still up there at the bottle. I'm wondering too if he'll go straight into the bottle and just leave it as a normal stick, or if he wants to finish up the wand. Bamboo. Still not harassing Krilly as much as I thought he would. He's got a really decent creep wave here, and this probably be his main reason for it. But that bear is dropping down low, forced to be pulled back, and maybe even forced to resummon. See if he wants to risk it. Nose bottling up the illusion rune now, so RMN, not spending his 600 gold, hasn't made his decision just yet. There's T-Zar and Coddle. Get a smoke and rotate. Corey was bringing that in for them. Now they got 3 heroes to choose from, but it looks like they want bottom lane. They want Krilly. I want to give this advantage back over to Bamboo, who right now is 6-for-2 up against a 14-for-6 lone druid. But the call has to come out as well. Like 4FC, they're pulling, they're farming. And Krilly's a long way down right now. He's got no wards on the side. He has to know this rotation would have to come at some point. And that's why you see him move a little bit further back. He's really not sure about this. Now NA, smoke's been broken, but already the initial stun. There's your impale. Hits as well as the Coddle Blast, but I don't think they've got enough damage. Shuri Toss combined, it's not enough. They'll have to dive it in, and Pylai Dai can't do that. They needed more time. They need to be further down, but they felt the same thing. NA came in a little bit too close. Then he got revealed out. And when that happened, it was just like, oh, go, okay, go, 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 go. Let's see if we can make this work for us. And it didn't. So we sit at 0-for-1. 1,000 gold and just about, 500 experience going their way. As we see a lane switch over. So Bamboo now with level 4 comes up towards the top lane. And we'll start screwing around up here while we see Krilly have to deal with now an aggressive tri lane. Same time, Batrider's looking to scout it out with just an illusion rune, which just pops off, and I mean, time's out. Bamboo. Unless he finds some CS up here, even if it's at the expense of the dire pull. He still finds a little bit. Protected. And that gets Quatschka back into farming ways. So really, he's fallen behind right now. The lone druid on the offlane at 23-for-6, he's already way too strong. And then you look over towards our top lane with Kunkka. Hasn't got a hell of a lot, but he's still 15-for-0 up against a 17-for-6. And that's meant to be the two safe laners for either side. The guys are meant to be babysat. Got Sentry Ward pick up. Well, Bamboo, bit of trouble now. Pick up, Boomski, able to get the easiest ice path of his life and the Jewel Breath, plus the Torrent, Bamboo's death.
The trail goes cold.
And that is the problem when you've got such great control. The setup of the Rubik, pick up a telekinesis, then the ice path. Guaranteed stun whenever someone's inside it, so it's an instant stun too, so Bounty Hunter can't move away, even if he tries to, like you saw them. You got the Torrent follow-up, then you got the Sentry Wards, which still keep the extra vision. And this is just good support work coming out from 4FC. They're keeping their eyes across the map, and Bamboo hasn't worked out as the best Bounty Hunter just yet. Too many lane changes around. And Kunkka, even if Bamboo is in Viz, what's he got that up on Tidebringer? 3 points in Tidebringer. Pushes the lane a little bit further, but with the pulls that are coming out from the rest of 4FC, like even if this change around, man, this is a really great play by Strangby. He sees Bamboo move up, so he rotates around himself to ensure this Tidebringer hits on its target, keeping Bamboo at half of his life with just two hits. As RMN looking, 24-for-1 up against a 33-for-5. Noah's already with the lasso and a haste rune right now. And that's why Puck is hanging back as far as he can behind the tree line. Still wants to stay in experience range, but those that knows can just initiate on him at any time. And Bamboo, he's already rotating again. He's got level 6, so he's going to track up the middle lane and see if he can come in for a kill. And there's not being in combination here with RMN. For the first, yep, there goes Puck ulti, Janata as well, Firefly is doing his damage, but with the track bonus, they should be able to chase it down. In fact, Puck going to orb himself in range of the T1 tower. Dangerous things to do, but they still get the kill nonetheless. But RMN force tank up that tower, and it is actually going to be his, ooh, nice face. Still cops a little bit of that blast, and one more right click. He lets off the bottle charges, maybe one right click won't be enough. Bottle charge keeps him alive, and the magic wand really helped out as well. Still nice little sight there for Boomski to rotate himself in towards that middle lane. Saw the retreat coming out and saw maybe there was a small opportunity. But RMM, an experienced Puck player, won't be caught out by something like that. And this means now Batrider dies a little bit, but it's okay for him. Like 7 minutes in, he's already wandering around with one Tranquil's bottle. Like that's enough for him. The Blink Dagger will come in time, but for 7 minutes, he's looking good. Same for Kunkka. Kunkka with Phase Boots. He could have been looking a lot worse, but he's caught up now. 33-for-0. He gets to hold Bamboo off the lane. The bright side, though, for KP just then was with that kill. That was a track kill for Bamboo. So he gets cash from that one. 150 gold for himself, and he gives an extra 50 gold over towards the Puck on top of the normal kill points. Kill gold. And Pilei die as well as Danae catching up through some nice double pulling and stacking. While Cruelly tries to stay on top by having a crack at these Ancients. But we still haven't seen... a tower drop from anybody. But that's no surprise with the lineup we see from 4FC. It's not the way their lineup is built. Cruelly uses... There's some serious bear micro. Yeah, now they're pushing come on the tower. But it's just a premature push. They can bring it down a little bit. And actually, because they do have a passive bounty hunter, it does make this possible that they can force down the tower bit by bit. But Bambi does a good job. He is the Shuri toss, so he doesn't get himself in range of a telekinesis. And that makes him capable of just pulling the aggro down. And that forces 4FC off the tower. At the same time, we see Puck come up. Up towards the top lane. He's keeping himself nicely split. Leaves a copy of himself in middle lane. And tries to make it look like there's two illusions up here on the top lane. And now with three heroes. Nice ulti. Bamboo starts off the track with Rubik. He's the first one they want. Nice ship and Torrent. Holding T-Zar out. But then again, the Spy Carapace working against 4FC. And there goes the orb. Should be a follow through up. And yeah, they'll kill up the Rubik. He's the easier one. And last right click by Puck gets the kill. Now over towards the Kunkka. T-Zar's trying to chase him. But now he's lassoed in. So now we see the rotation coming out from both Batrider. Didn't pull him all the way up to the Torrent, which I thought he would have done. Instead, he keeps him in the Firefly. Keeps him burning. Two napalm stacks more than enough, and Bamboo looked to dive, in fact did dive and pick off the Kunkka. So another kill going the way of Bamboo. Looks like he was short of mana, so either he got that track off very early on, or it was only one track kill coming out for KP during that engagement. But did buy time for Pinelight Die to get a little bit of experience in the middle lane. Of course, that was when RMN rotated out. Yeah, a little bit of advantage goes the way of KP after that engagement. Experience starts to level up a little bit too. And PL in the meantime, free farming on the bot. 56 for 16. Still like gold per minute. It's a little bit lower. It's because Batrider's being involved in engagements, but still where it needs to be for that PL. And we'll see if he goes Diffusal to start with, or if we go into the Radiance build. But Radiance is reduced a little bit by the Null Field, but most Rubik's unable to get that until later on in the game. Like later on in the game. See points up in the ultimate, we see points up in telekinesis and Fade Bolt, and then you look towards the Null Field. Even though it's a nice field to have, there's more important things to get. RMN trying to make the most out of his life. Stacking, successful. But 2400 for PL. It doesn't really look like he's either gonna just like pop out with a Diffusal Blade out of nowhere. Or we see him go down the different line. Dyer's and that's the Radiance. At the same time, Lone Druid, what's he building up towards? Orb of Venom. Also, we got dual Radiances coming out. That's what it feels like. Well, Batrider saving up for his Blink Dagger, same with Puck. Puck a lot closer. But that's also because Batrider ended up buying more things. He actually finished off his full Tranquil Boots in comparison to Puck. He's walking around with Wand, Bottle, and then just normal boots. That's a little bit further back as far as farm goes, but it's still decent enough. And Batrider. Nice time to move back. If he followed that crit wave up, he would have copped a nice little bit of burst damage, but he moved up. Looking for the 12-minute rune on top. Won't spawn there. In fact, it's going to be an invis on the bottom. The Dioside making sure they're the only guys with vision of this because they have the Observer and Sentry Ward watching the bottom lane. And they babysit it up for the Batrider. So we get an invis Batrider initiation at the same time. Boomski rotates towards the bottom lane with Rubik. But if they're looking to add some pressure towards that town, but Pilei Dire is down here with NA as well. And they find the pair to start with. I'm gonna have to fall back in range of the tower. And then more support. So Kunkka now comes in towards the mix too. They know they're not being seen. Another Sentry Warden. Pilei Dire way too far out of position. Ice Path way too far off target. Same with the Torrent. Pilei Dire might have a chance to get out of this one. X marks the spot. It's the ship coming in fact. And the ship is a complete fail boat. And now NA, they can turn this one around. 4FC miss all of their abilities. Hey, why not? Nice Torrent. Only go on to NA and the Spy Carapace returns it. And then an Invis Nose comes in. Looks for this lasso. Gets up on the PL. It's going to be the bigger kill to come out in this one. Even though they've already lost their lone Druid.
from above.
Boomski sticks around. So Lone Druid dying up on top, so Iron Man and Bamboo teaming up together for that one. Well, the engagement, the fuss on bottom lane was happening. Both Coddle and PL. Both going down, and that was a really weird position. All he wanted to do, I think, was plant a ward in behind and then de-warded it himself. But they had no vision up there. The support was a little bit too far away. And the creep wave also wasn't with them. It was safer times to do that kind of stuff. And that wasn't one of those safer times. And now he'll come up to do what he wanted to do. Observer ward. Man, he'll have to drop the sentry too. If he doesn't drop the sentry, it's not going to work, because the creep wave is going to start to attack the wall when it comes down. Quadfica actually going to, well, hold him off for now. And now Rubick. Yeah, he starts up on the D ward. He's got the possibility to go on the PL. Picks him up, throws him down. He did do the double walk, but it was the fake one that was walking away. It was the real one sticking with him. Double walk being stolen. Iron Man's going to jump himself into this one. And Rubick hides inside the invis. Moving back as far as he possibly can. Nice stun going out on Boomski. Is there a pick up and throw out? We've got no Fade Bolt mana available in the Ice Path. We'll hold Iron Man in position for the moment. Faze shifts up a little bit. There's the pick up and the follow through. That Torrent able to get his latch on. Now Puck throws out the ulti. It's the last thing he can do. Nice stun by NA, but not enough for the mana burn to kill off the Rubick. Living through it all. Same with Boomski. Living on such low life. But that telekinesis made it so the Torrent was going to hit her, or else Puck could have just orbed himself away or. Well, done his little slippery little sucker thing. And got away to safety. So no waste in the end. Oh, Strangby. Imagine if PL had a damage dealing item. Wait, he does! That's why he did a little bit more damage than what he would have. Diffuser Blade is where he wants to go. Bamboo will deny the top tower. Nice time to TP in. That was definitely a shift click moment. PL goes down to finish up his Diffuser Blade. This has been a bit of a, I won't say KP's going to be really happy with their engagement before. I say 4FC will be happy with their engagement before on bottom lane. Really felt like they had a lot more control over this game than what they do. They managed to drag it back a little bit with a couple of these kills on bot. But that first engagement, when we saw Torrent miss, we saw Ship miss, we saw Jakiro's Ice Path. That's kind of where it all fell apart was with Jakiro's Ice Path. The line just wasn't right for it. But now we have Blink Lasso up on nose. So the initiation has to come from him. Caught a blast and orb. And creep wave gone. They can do some nice damage to this T1 tower in mid. But that's always see Kunkin moving himself in. Still doesn't finish up that Shadow Blade. Starts off with the Torrent, and I think they see him coming in. Or they at least feel it coming in. And move themselves back to safety. Well, NA returns towards the bottom lane. Vendetta for him. The pings are coming off. Have they got a sentry ward up on the side? Yeah, they got one inside the tree line. So they can see T-Zar wanting to initiate. And they might wait for him to come out a little bit further. And you can see him use his Vendetta. And now the Firefly. Language escapes me. And Bamboo. Two Invis heroes, and they got two runes. Bamboo dragged through, Fae bolted, Ice passed up to, he's getting fired and iced everything they've got. Bamboo goes down. Iron Man TP didn't try and help out. He does have that Blink plus 12 wand charges up his sleeve, but it's just not enough today. And now Ice Path, can he jaunt out? He blinks out. But this is some fun control coming from the bottom lane. From Batrider, I think he wants to go again. Well, at least he will in 38 seconds, holding the regen rune for now. And Krilly back up towards the top lane, still working towards that Radiance. Now he knows there's only going to be one Radiance on the field. A lot happier about life while Boomski. And the amount of sentry wards purchased up for this game from him is unbelievable. But hey, there's no cooldown on him, so hey, why not keep buying him? And only 150 for normal observer wards is a bargain for all support heroes. The sale on wards. Going once, going twice. Diffuser Blade now finished for Quatrica. So he finally gets his first item now done. I'm not going to count Tranquil Boots. And NA might be looking to initiate on middle lane. Their sentry wars and all the other lanes kind of feel that it's been like controlling their entire jungle and tier 1 tower. So middle lane might have a little extra space. T-Zar wants to go in. Bamboo already has. He's diving a long way in to catch off nose. Keeps the damage going, but Nose can now blink himself away to save it if he so desires, or blink himself back in again, which he does do so. Lasso up on the PL. Stumble hold him there with the mana burn, but already the follow-up has killed off the PL. Shift flies in, hits absolutely nothing. RMM was smack bang in the middle of it. And NA is limping himself away. Straight one right click, not enough. One stick charge is in fact going to do the job. Turns around for a stun. Nice little juke around T-Zar, but Torrent perfect. By Carapace will return it, so Strainby can easily chase him down, but then phase boots, right click destruction. Conoblast still fishing around while Bamboo is searching for that Jakiro, or for the Rubick. Rubick on lower life, so probably the better one. He needs to keep the tracks up if he wants to have that vision, but now the track wears off. And Rubick gets himself a nice little heal, coming from his good old friend. Another push can happen on the lanes. Quilly's already added a lot of pressure towards that top. He gets an instant entangle up on Quatrica. So there's another relic up on the bear. And now a little bit more trouble for Bamboo. Again, walking in range of Sentry Wards, bouncing him in and around. Another Sentry Ward to be dropped on down. They can't control him in here, but he walks back in range of the second Sentry Ward. If he kept walking east, he would have been fine. But he didn't notice the second ward being dropped down. Of course, when you're running from a whole team of people, you see so many Sentry Wards anyway in the back of Boomski, you probably think, well, what's the point? I can juke around the trees and use the Fog of War instead. And get Batrider up in his high Firefly horse, and running away from him is very, very difficult. I hate to think how many kills we've already seen going the way of Bounty Hunter. 2 for 4, in fact. And there's 5 for 1 going the way of the Batrider. So he's having a great old time. Boomski taking it for the team. If that Tauren hit, it would have been a full-up Macropyre and Ice Path from Death of Puck. Because they already used his Fade, he already used his Orb. And instead, they'll just babysit the Roshan attempt. Ping's already coming out by Bamboo. It's like, yo, dude, look what's happening. Strangby, ooh, trouble for him in mid lane. He looks to go down, but then turns around. Nice lasso and 4-star for him, and back in range of the tower. Follow-up Tauren tried to come in by Kunkka. One charge is keeping him in a little bit of a safer position. The puck on the sideline is trying to initiate on a lone Kunkka. Would have had it if support wasn't just there. Denial of the mid tower might be a nice idea too. I think they're trying to keep it up until Roshan is done. And PL Illusions will scout out Quilly going on it. He can't resummon this bear just yet, so he can't solo this completely. Just pulls him back, got 16 more seconds to wait, while T-Zar is adding pressure towards the bottom lane. This is a nice item now for Kunkka to have. Full Shadow Blade completed. Krilly's healing himself up, and then we'll resummon and go back in for Roshan. But Roshan's also doing the same thing. He's healing up too. These illusions come in to scout out, but never got vision of the life points of Roshan. And then towards the bottom lane. Pick up by Rubick. What did he end up stealing? We end up stealing 4 points in Impale. He's adding another stun now the way of 4FC. It's like Kunkka TP'd up towards the top lane to deny the tier 1 tower out too. A little bit of extra gold coming the way of KP, but not as much as they really, really wanted to. That line, bad. Draw it a little bit harder there, Rubick. Come to Roshan. Oh, T-Zar, Ice Path, trouble for him. Death for him. Track is up on Jakiro, and the Cataclysm did some nice damage, but that is all. And they will finish up Roshan. Lone Druid picks up the Aegis, the Immortal. And getting closer and closer towards that Radiance money. It's going to be a little bit late. That's not too bad considering all the lane rotations that happened. And the pressure that was applied. Boomski. A little more careful there, man. Conoblast will do those kind of things to you. And we'll see another one coming too. This is really nice positioning coming out from Pylidae. Just on the edge, maybe not as nice positioning. You need to be a little bit further up and around this region here. But then he would have been visible. Batrider's already searching for him. And now Blink looking for Puck, can't find him. Firefly destroys off every single tree, so no surprises coming the way here of KP. And it will be the tier 1 tower being theirs. Another Cotter Blast, but no one in range this time around. But that should be Radiance money. He's still just a little bit short. And then Nose finds an Invis rune. Trouble for PL if he's not careful, especially with that gem already up on the Batrider. And that's where you see PL Quatrica TPing himself back out to safety. There's nowhere safe on the map now. Vision-wise, or to initiate. So I'm kind of a little bit surprised about KP's lineup. If you look through it, like, you've got Bounty Hunter who runs around Invis, you've got NA that runs around Invis, and then you've got a Doppelwalking PL. So you've got three heroes that rely on Invis to escape. all it's going to take is a gem to counter. It's like looking at techies. Just buy a gem and then slowly look down the lane. No need to initiate. Now T-Zar is dead. Lasso, 4-star, back in range of the Tier 2 tower. He's just out of range of the Tier 2 tower. Spy Carapace buying him a little bit of time, but not enough. And there's NA. The one to get killed up by the creep wave that came in. One of the other heroes around him was stunned up. And Kunkka. Can he one hit? Can he one hit Pylai die? I don't think so. Yeah, Shadowblade's going to wear off anyway, so he hides inside the tree line. He needed more support. Need a lot more support down there. And Rubick as well as Lone Druid are in the neighborhood, but I don't think they're ready to fight just yet. That Lone Druid bear healing up, or is it on off lane? It's on off lane. It's pushing with the Radiance Burn already. Well, Nose is able to farm up the middle lane. Another Cold Blast looking to hold him out. Yeah, 1 point up in Null Field. Gives him a little bit of extra resistance, but it doesn't help him enough. We see another Illuminate Blast. And through the creep wave, and then Rubick cops the full brunt of it. But they want to force out this bottom tower. It's the problem of Coddle, he could just slow this down so much. And PL is farming up with nothing but fakes. He won't be able to finish the job. Fate helps out Krilly to get these last hits in. And Batrider Fireflying again. He wants to look behind the tower, but no one's here. KP have resigned themselves to saying this bottom tower is not ours. We can't hold it, so why defend it? Let NA farm up a little bit more in middle lane. Coddle's going to start stacking or farming up inside the jungle. Puck just doesn't want to be part of it. And Bamboo searching for other kills. Building up towards Vladimir's offering. And PL's farming up top lane. Almost 3k gold up on him now. Look to see if he gets up that heart. We see Butterfly. Heart's been the way of most PLs. But that's normal if you have like a Radiance Rift. No, even if you don't have a Radiance, it's still fine. And that's mid lane. Tier 2 town. Oh, they're going to try and defend this one. Boomski in the middle of it. He got a nice Ice Path off. X marks the spot, pushes T-Zar back in. He's still in range of that tower, so he's still visible. Puck's finally going to get rid of this. And Jakiro able to deny it. Puck was attempting it. And now the Radiance Burn. Tracker's up as well, so okay, we see a little bit of extra movement speed for RMN. He's gonna... Oh, he TP's in. Nose, Flame breaks him out. Well, say TP's out, but can't hold it. I apologize to my grammar today. I don't know what's going on with my tongue. Just going to go mad with the tongue. We are 4-15 now up on the board. And Nose... Almost finished a full Shiva's Guard, just needs a recipe for it, and that's not far off. And with the double damage, he'll have it here in the middle lane. Easy as pie. Speaking of which, Coddle, no items really whatsoever. Oh, hello! Yeah, he does. Makes a lot more sense for a 26-minute Coddle. He's also been farming up the creep waves. Able to get that mech up. Still a little bit too late. 4.2k up on PL as well. Kind of want to see him pick up that Reaver as well as Vitality Booster. But looks like he hasn't decided to do so just yet. At least the bottom lane pushing out with copies of himself. And Coddle, got to be careful not to be caught out. Curly comes in, but this warding is just not there again from 4FC. All the wards have timed out from their great start from Boomski. And it's just because our wards are on cooldown? No, he's still got one in stock and not buying. And you always got sentry wards. But the vision for the Radiant side, that's a little bit different. This is their only aggressive ward on the map. Got one sentry ward here for de-warding. And that is basically a full summary. And then rotation top lane. Looking for Quatrica. He goes inside the trees. They're a little bit late with the Batrider turning up. So they got no extra vision of him. But then Blink, Puck Aldi, Iron Man wants to go in, but then again we have Nose, Blink, and tries to finish it in him. They see T-Zar moving up, and then the Lasso holding the NA out of position, also killing him off that bear, really focusing him down. And now Quatrica, Mech Charge keeping him alive for a little bit longer, but not long enough. And Pylai die, retreats back in range of his own base. At the same time, Iron Man now up with the Kunkka, pull back in again. Nice little phase shift, avoids the Torrent, and Sexy Bamboo, the chasing after him. Bamboo's even copying a little bit of splash damage down. A nice TP out in time. RMM back to safety. And Bamboo will keep on the edge here of Kunkka. He doesn't have a lot of damage, but what he does have is going to cause Conker a couple of issues. The pings are coming out saying, yo, guys, search room. He's like, yep, we're taking top racks. Park, really? Did he jump in on that? Seriously, though, that's a defensive orb. But he went into the middle of 4FC, and this is going to be an easy racks. Krillikov's a little of extra damage. He can't resummon. And this is frustrating for him. They just lost the Radiance. An orb to go. Track up. Shuri toss. Plus a little of extra right click. A lot of damage coming the way of Rubick. And stun out in Jakiro. Coddle Blast just off to the side. Gets an extra burst damage to kill off Boomski. He's got nice path, but can't cast anything when Silence Wand. Tries to keep him alive for the moment. And he just pulls himself back down a lot. Just moves down a little bit. Forces KP to turn around to kill him off. And that means 4FC's remaining heroes can retreat out to safety. But the second they lost that bear, they had to fall themselves back. Took out the tower, showed they can force the fights. Really? Three stack? Should use your Shadow Blade to go for that one, man. Yeah, we go. Shadow Blade plus the Tidebringer and Torrent. Nice farm coming his way. Nothing up on the courier. No, still hasn't bought up the recipe for it. Another Torrent. Steals two of them. And leaves at least one for Rubick. He already got his four staff. He doesn't need much more. Tzar, however, is looking for his life. He needs more. He needs kills. But can't find it. RMN's here too. They're looking for blood. At least Pylai dies, finding a little bit more farm again. Not just buying that mech and being raw mech. So CS looking like 187 coming the way of PL. It's getting a lot fatter, but again though, he hasn't spent any of this cash. It's on the courier. Is there something? He's just trying to save for buyback. But with the Reaver and Vitality Boost, with all these extra life points, it might be enough to like play around a lot more with 4FC, but he holds it. And now we see Split Push, Bamboo and RMM pushing at the top lane. Middle tower is under attack. While there's PL trying to push up against a Conker who's already got crit. And that's a dangerous thing to go up against. We know the power of Conker destroyed lanes, even though the percentage is a lot lower now. Looking for the fire flying. There we go, nose. Breaking himself off the top. Another Coddle Blast. It just keeps these lanes pushed out and makes it so hard for 4FC to push in. They have to force it like they did the top lane. But even then, Coddle by himself is able to solo hold that. And now Krilly and Boomski pushing out that mid. But they've got to worry about this bottom lane. Already Conker. Yeah, there you go. Double TP's coming in. Fable, pick up, throw down. Bamboo still in range of the tower, but he's out far enough. And there's no mana to follow up. In fact, well, I'm surprised Kunker's not using his wand charges just yet. He wants to use the Shadow Blade hit. That's not really there for him. T-Zar's on the way out. Looks like Spy Carapace buys him a little bit of extra space. And then smoke up by Bamboo. Remember, knows to walk around with a gem. Can blink himself up and give some vision to Bamboo. In fact, does do so right on top of him. There's the lasso. Hold him in position. Hold him there for the Torrent, which does follow through. And the Ice Pass. Bamboo so dead. At the same time, NA getting entangled and brought down. Krilly catching him out of position. And has a full Assault Cuirass now finished too. Needs to keep himself alive. And now Puck will throw the ulti down. Tries to split himself up. Krilly avoids the damage out in himself, but cannot avoid the damage on the bear. And now he just lost everything. Shouldn't be resummoning right now, but he wants to fight and turn on RMN. If he lives, it's okay. If he dies, it's going to be absolutely horrendous, but he lives, so it's okay. Pylai die. Shiva's guarded to death. So Puck 1, Coddle 1, NA 1, and Bounty on the other. And a tier 2 tower to go down in mid. The creep wave will push in through the mid. And Coddle will buy it back to stall it off. 4FC will have to do the same thing. They'll have to move themselves back. Roshan is now respawned too, so their timing is perfect for this. Move in for Roshan. They got a Soul Cuirass Aura. And they got Kunker, who just wants to finish up his Daedalus. And he buys a Demon Edge at least, but this is Strangby buying out for this. They could be cautious if this happens. They lose their entire team. I suppose when Aegis Mortar behind you, you feel a lot more confident. But if they lose their entire team and lose mid-racks, this game turns around completely. There goes Roshan. another Aegisthi Maul to go in the way of Krillie, so even if he dies, his bear will remain. And Bounty gets himself a little bit of consolation prize, like the steak knives coming out. Know what I'm talking about. Have those game shows, you always get like the steak knives at the end of it. The haste rune is what I'm talking about for him. And Bear has a bit of a look around. Bit of a Radiance burn. And Radiance is bought up by PL, so he did still buy Radiance at the end of the day. It's another item that lets him turtle, but a 30-minute Radiance, it's really not going to have as much of an effect as they would desire. Mainly because PL Illusions won't remain up. If they all come in one big go, Kunkka will destroy them with one swing of his blade. And now they're searching for Bamboo. Maybe feeling he's on the top lane, and Batrider even building up his own heart. Reaver's there for him. These PL Illusions just have no stability. He has to at least get a Vitality Booster right now. Sitting at 1,800 gold, but only 1,000 life points. It's not enough for him. He's reliant heavily on these Illusions, having enough time to live to do the Radiance Burn. And this is where the effectiveness kind of goes out the window. You need to have the life points to keep the Radiance burning, and then you also don't want to have all these heroes, like Kunkka's walking around with 1,500 life points, Krillie with 2.2k. And then 2k up in the Batrider. Radiance Burn doesn't affect them at all. They start up on the ranks. Everyone has to come back. Fortification going to pop too, but they let it go. Fortification is too late. Nodes are still looking for the initiation. But it's like KP aren't ready for this. The Tractor there up on two heroes, but their Rakt is gone. Then Blink in, searching for one. Spy Carapace already baited out. Bottom lane, that push is coming by PL. And that's a nice momentum. And that will force 4FC to come back, but directly to the tower. There's your Tauren hit into Shadow Blade, and then right click cleans up the rest of the wave, or most of it at least. And the tier 2 tower has helped. Meanwhile, up on the top lane, Jakiro able to catch up Bounty Hunter, fucking a phase shift. Does she have enough orb? It's a blink. Enough time to blink away to safety as Nose 4 starts himself in the middle of the fight. Napalm is going to get defused to start off with, and Quatrica, flame break back in closer. There's no telekinesis, and we actually got Warning Rift. Stolen out right now from Rubick. So he had a silence as well to all towards this pool of abilities that are on 4FC. In fact, they managed to snipe off Bounty Hunter again. Kunkka's the one doing mop-up work, but this also lets him afford up a Daedalus. So it turns around, right-click. On the next Tidebring, he'll clean up the rest of the Creep Wave. Yep, there we go. Farm for him. And that's Daedalus done. Regeneration! Now we combine it all together with the damage and the crit. How long we got left on this Aegis the Immortal? It wasn't even lost. And we get a Vladimir's Offering too. Having the way of Lone Druid, give that creep wave a little bit more momentum behind it with the lifesteal. Nari is looking a little bit poorer than before. He didn't buy anything. Nothing sitting on the deck. There's the Vlad's by Krillie. So I'm just going to now finally be picked up and brought down towards the bottom lane. And 4FC doing the wise thing. They split push this. Well, not 100% really. And the bear to one point can push. But the top creep wave pushes out itself because it's mega creeps. And then all they got to do is fall themselves up in the bottom. Well, Jeb now reveals out the fact that warding is here. Observer wards and D wards up in the high ground. KP can't get close enough to stop that. Normal fly through as well as a Coddle Blast, so this creep wave already looking for initiation. They don't care about that. All they want is these kills. Naruman, Lasso, they got it. He got him. And now the silence following up here by Rubick. That was going to stolen by Puck. They get the kill out in Puck, so his ulti is now gone. And Spy Carapace is stolen too. Double kill for Krillie. And this Coddle Blast is minimal damage. There's no PL here. He's up on the top lane trying to push it all out. But the bottom ranks will go. There's no fortification. Coddle Blast are whittling them down bit by bit, but when you're two Rakdos behind, a tier 2 tower is not enough to balance this exchange out. And then a quick rotation towards the middle lane. Krillie almost wants to die right now. And he's getting close to the point of doing it. How long have we got before? He's got one more minute left on that Aegis the Immortal. More than enough time. And that is going to be four staff down, looking for a pickup. Pylite dies already dead. Lasso is off cooldown in a moment. But Bamboo picked up, completely visible. He will go down. It is Mega Creeps, and well, attempting here is Quatrica to push in through the top. But with all the Rakdos down and Mega Creeps to face up, even PL's Illusions won't be enough. They're TPing out of this one, which I really don't see why. Boomski will get caught out a little bit. And Teaser, well, knows it's just going to go solo on him with Krilly. And maybe this is the whole thing. Couple of heroes to come back and defend up against it. Knows chasing that Iron Man. Shiva's guard will slow him down enough. Plus the Napalm stack. Can phase shift himself out of this one if he needs to. But he'll just jaunt out to safety. The Rakt is defended. And Krilly is mopping up the mess in the middle, in basically back in the Radiant space. Kotchka, do what he can to try and bring down Krilly. But remember, that Agassi Maul is going to expire soon, so he kind of wants to die and get his life back again. Cut a blast. Yeah, here he goes. Aegis will trigger. The bear, however, will also go down, even if it does get a little bit of extra burst damage back in ulti form. How long did he have left on that? It was only a couple of extra seconds. And the bear opens up, and that's Pylite die. He'll burn to death before he gets back to base here. Yep, Lone Druid gets it. And again, that large amount of damage to the bear. He's got no real stay ability. Puck Orb, he's gonna jump in front. There's a stun. So that'll kill the bear off at least. There's no resummon for this. But there's definitely Nose on the front lines. Wanting to jump in. Force stuff up and then find Krilly. Track him up, try and kill him off. Puck able to orb himself away to safety. While the Lone Druid's taking Bamboo on a bit of a run around the block. But the Mega Creeps are gonna be approved to be too much. There's Achiever's Guard, Iron Man's death now. Should be dead. Is he gonna blink out of this one to safety? Yeah, he does. Slippery little sucker. But we've got Mega Creeps coming down for 4FC, everywhere on all lanes. Even if Bamboo wants to fight up right here, it's... yeah. Lone Druid's back to safety. GG is the call. Surprise it actually took this long. But KP wanting to fight to the very last moment. But this is GG. So the base gets to go down. KP on the receiving end of a loss now. And 4FC going to feel even more comfortable when it comes to their group stage. And well, KP, they need, well, so 4FC feels comfortable. KP feels a little bit unsettled. And they've got one more game to come. Tonight, KP, they're going up against HWA, the boys from Turkey. That'll be our second game of the evening. We finish up tonight with Root Gaming going up against Baguette. That will be the final games of the evening. But of course, as you'll see right now, we'll update this in our break. But as HWA is still looking for their first win in here in the group, and KP, they're looking for a way to get themselves back into this group and keep their hopes alive in the defense. Stick around. We'll see if they can do it. We'll be back.
I said good day, sir.